Hey there, welcome to Active Finance YouTube channel. Hope you will be fine and I'm also fine. So we have completed the first chapter of this course, Accounting Principles, and hope you guys also have completed all video tutorials and related exercises. Now we are going to start the second chapter of this course, which is the recording process. As in first chapter, we analyzed business transactions in terms of accounting equation and we presented the cumulative effects of these transactions in tabular form. Now imagine a company like MF Global using that same tabular format as SoftBite did to keep track of its transactions. In a single day, MF Global engaged in thousands of transactions to keep each transaction. This way would be impractical, expensive, and unnecessary. So instead of that, companies use a set of procedures and records to keep track of transaction data more easily. So this chapter introduces and illustrates these basic procedures and records. So let's get started. Alright, welcome back. So these are the learning objectives of second chapter, the recording process. The first in this chapter is describe how accounts, debits and credits are used to record the business transactions. Second is indicate how a journal is used in recording process. Third is explain how a ledger and posting helps in recording process. The fourth and last one is prepare a trial balance. So in this tutorial we will just discuss the first learning objective. So in first learning objective, first we have to understand the accounts, debits and credit rules are used to record the business transaction. So first of all, the account. An account is an individual accounting record of increases and decreases in a specific assets, liabilities or owner's equity items. So the account shows the changes in increases or decreases of these items. For example, SoftBite, the company which was discussed in first chapter, would have separate accounts for a cash account. Now cash was the in which we have entered the cash payments and cash receipts. Now account receivable, this is the second account. So account receivables, in which we will receive the amount in near future. The third account is accounts payable. So the accounts payable is the account in which we enter our liabilities and service revenue. Now the amount which we will generate by providing the services. And salaries. Now salaries are the fixed, we will pay to the employees on a monthly basis. And wages, we will pay to the employees on daily basis. So this was the difference between salary and expense. Now the one thing that you have to keep in mind, note that whenever you are referring to a specific account, we must capitalize the name. You have seen in previous account names that the all letters are capitalized of account. In its simplest form, an account consists of three parts. The account includes three parts. The first is a title. First we will give the title of account, and then the second left are debit side. We will mention the left side, or also it is called the debit side of account. And the third, a right side or credit side. We have to mention these three things in an account, because the format of an account resembles the letter T. We refer to it as a T account. It also referred as T account. Illustration 2.1 shows the basic form of account. So this is the form or basic form of account, in which we have mentioned first the title of account, and then we will mention the left or debit side, and then राइट साइड और क्रेडिट साइड. सो दिस इज द बेसिक फॉर्म ऑफ एन अकाउंट. नाउ वी हैव अंडरस्टूड व्हाट इज द अकाउंट. नाउ व्हाट आर द डेबिट्स एंड क्रेडिट्स. सो वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दीज टू टर्म्स. द टर्म डेबिट इंडिकेट्स द लेफ्ट साइड ऑफ एन अकाउंट एंड द क्रेडिट इंडिकेट्स द राइट साइड ऑफ एन अकाउंट. दे कॉमनली एब्रीविएटेड. यू कैन ऑल्सो एब्रीविएट डेबिट एंड क्रेडिट एज डेबिट DR for debit and CR for credit. They are mostly mentioned in reports as DR and CR. So you will have to understand that they are a debit and credit. They do not mean increase or decrease as is commonly thought. We use the terms debit and credit repeatedly in recording process to describe where entries are made in account. So they help in us to describe that the entries where are made in account. For example, the act of entering an account on the left side is called the debiting the account, and making an entry on right side is known as crediting the account. When you enter the entry on left side, it is known as debiting the account, and when we will make the entry on right side, it is known as credit account. When we comparing the totals of two sides, when we compare the two sides of account, an account shows the debit balance if the total debit amount exceeds the credit amount, then it shows the debit balance. When an account shows a credit balance if the credit amount exceeds the debit, then it shows the credit balance. Now this is the numerically illustration to clarify the concept. The illustration shows the tabular summary and account form of the SoftBytes cash account. So we have taken this data from the cash account of the SoftBytes. So this is the summary of cash. The 15,000 in red, which are invested by the owner. So the values which are in positive, we will mention these values in debit, and which like this minus $7,000 are we will in minus. That's why we will put the on credit side. So after putting these values in minus on credit side and plus in debit side, then we will minus debits from credit. The debits exceeding to the credits, it shows the debit balance. Let's look on other related problems or illustrations which are involved related to debit and credit and debit balancing and credit balancing. This is the second example, debit and credit related. If the sum of debit entries are greater than the sum of credit entries, the account will have the debit balance. So this is the illustration. This is the transaction one, in which the $10,000 are on debit side. In second transaction, there are $3,000 on credit side, and in third transaction there are 8,000 on credit side. When we will mention enter all transaction, then we will minus the debits from credits. If debits are exceeding from the credits, then it shows the debit balance as we learned in previous illustration. Now when we will minus these values from the credit, these values exceed from the credit, that's why it's showing the debit balance, which is $15,000. Let's do another problem or illustration which shows the credit balance. Now this is the second example related to debit and credit. If the credit entries are greater than the sum of debit entries, the account will have the credit balance. So in debit, first transaction shows that we have entered in debit $10,000, and in क्रेडिट साइड सेकेंड एंड थर्ड ट्रांजेक्शन इन विच वी हैव इंटर्ड द 3000 एंड 8000 व्हेन वी विल माइनस फ्रॉम दिस वैल्यू द 10,000 देन इट एक्सीड्स फ्रॉम द डेबिट बैलेंस दैट्स वाई इट शोज द क्रेडिट बैलेंस विच इज $1,000. सो नाउ लेट्स प्रोसीड फर्दर. वंस वी हैव डन दिस थिंग्स एंड न्यूमरिकली वी इंटर्ड द वैल्यूज एंड फाइंड आउट द डेबिट बैलेंस और क्रेडिट बैलेंस देन वी विल द क्वेश्चन अराइजेज दैट वॉट आर द लिमिटेशंस एंड इंटरप्रिटेशंस रिलेटेड टू डेबिट बैलेंसिंग एंड क्रेडिट बैलेंसिंग. नाउ लेट्स लर्न अबाउट द रिजल्ट्स एंड इंटरप्रिटेशन. नाउ एवरी पॉजिटिव आइटम इन अ टेबुलर समरी रिप्रेजेंटेड ऑफ कैश रिसिप्ट्स द पॉजिटिव कैश फ्लोज और पॉजिटिव values shows the cash receipts that we have received the cash which have we received or a negative amount represents a cash payments that we have paid to others or we have paid the expenses etc. Now these two things are clear that the positive values are cash receipts and negative values are a payment of cash. Now notice that in the account form we record the increases in cash as debit and decreases in cash as credit. So this thing we have to keep in mind that increases in cash we will record on debit side and decreases in cash we will record on credit side. Now for example the 15,000 cash receipts of cash in red which we have seen in the values which was in red color mentioned is the debited to cash because cash we have received the cash from the owner and the 7000 cash payments in blue which was credited in cash having increases on one side and decreases on other side reduces the recording errors and it helps determining the totals of each side of the account as well as the account balance. So there are three things involved which will help us in which we will know about the increase and decrease and it reduces the errors and helps the to determine totals of each sides of the account as well as the account balance. We will know three things of doing the debiting and crediting. The balance is determined by netting the two sides in which we are subtracting one amount from an other. The amount balance a debit of 8050 indicates that the soft bite had $8,050 more increases than the decreases in cash. In other words, you can say that the soft bite started with a zero balance. There was no profit of the soft bite at the beginning, and now it has $8,050 in its cash account. So the soft bite has the profit $8,050. So this is the interpretation of debit balance and credit balance. Now debit and credit procedures. In this the term is used as double entry system. As in first chapter we have learned that the effect of transaction on basic accounting equation. Remember that each transaction must affect two or more accounts to keep the basic accounting equation in balance. In other words, for each transaction, debits must equal to credits. The equality of debits and credits provide the basis for the double entry system of recording transactions. Under the double entry system, the dual or two-sided effects of each transaction is recorded is in appropriate accounts. This system provides a logical method for recording transactions and also helps ensure accuracy of recording accounts as well as detection of errors. If every transaction is recorded with equal debits and credits, the sum of all debits to the accounts must be equal to the sum of all credits. Now, the thing that we have to keep in mind that each transactions must affected two or more accounts in accounts to keep the basic accounting equation in balance. So this is the main point of the double entry system. And the second thing that we have to remember, which is recording done by the debiting at least one account and crediting at least one other account, and debits must equal to the credits in double entry system. Now the question arises that why we use the double entry system. The double entry system is used for determining the equality of accounting equation in is much more efficient than the plus and minus procedure used in first chapter. As we used in first chapter, we will learn about debit and credit procedures for assets and liabilities. If assets rises, then either we will enter in debit or credit. So let's learn the rules of debit and credit. DR or CR procedures for assets and liabilities. In illustration 2.2, for the soft bite increases in cash, as we noticed in previous slides, an asset were entered on left side and decreases in cash were entered on right side or credit side. We know that both sides of basic equation, which is assets is equals to liabilities plus owner's equity, must be equal. So we have to equal the basic accounting equation. It therefore follows that the increases and decreases in liabilities will have to be recorded the opposite from the increases and decreases in assets. Thus, increases in liabilities must be entered on right side or credit side, and decreases in liabilities must be entered on the left side or debit side. The effects that the debits and credits have on assets and liabilities. Let's see the illustration 2.3. Now, this is debit side and credit side. If our assets are increases, then we will mention in debit side, and if the liabilities decreases, then we will mention on debit side. If the our assets are decreases, then we will mention or enter these decreases in assets on credit side. When liabilities increases, they will be entered on right side. Now we have here understand that if our assets are increasing, they are recorded in debit side. If assets decreases, they are recorded on credit side. If the liabilities decreases, they are recorded on debit side, and if liabilities increases, they will be recorded on credit side. Asset accounts normally shows the debit balance. This is the terminology that shows that asset accounts normally shows the debit balance. That is, debits to the specific asset account should exceed credits to the account. Likewise, liabilities account normally shows the credit balance. Now these two things keep in mind, that asset account normally shows the debit balance and liabilities account normally shows the credit balance. That is, credits to a liability of account should exceed the debits to the account, to that account, the नॉर्मल बैलेंस ऑफ एन अकाउंट इज ऑन द साइड वेयर एन इंक्रीजेज इन अकाउंट इज रिकॉर्डेड. नाउ लेट्स सी द इलस्ट्रेशन 2.4 व्हिच शोज द नॉर्मल बैलेंसेज फॉर एसेट्स एंड लायबिलिटीज. नाउ व्हेन एसेट्स इंक्रीजेज डेबिट फॉर इंक्रीजेज इट शोज द नॉर्मल बैलेंस टू द एंड व्हेन द डेबिट डिक्रीजेज फॉर डिक्रीजेज एंड क्रेडिट्स इंक्रीजेज इट शोज द नॉर्मल बैलेंस टू क्रेडिट साइड. स्टिल वी हैव अंडरस्टैंड दैट एसेट अकाउंट शोज द नॉर्मल बैलेंस डेबिट बैलेंस एंड लायबिलिटी अकाउंट शोज द नॉर्मल क्रेडिट बैलेंस. नाउ डेबिट एंड और क्रेडिट प्रोसीजर्स फॉर ऑनर्स इक्विटी. वी हैव लर्न द टू अकाउंट्स एसेट अकाउंट एंड लायबिलिटी अकाउंट. नाउ वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड द ऑनर्स इक्विटी अकाउंट. एज इन फर्स्ट चैप्टर we indicated the owner's statement which was 15,000 and revenue increases owner's equity. Yes, we have learned when the revenue increases it shows the increase in owner's equity. Owner's drawing and expenses decreases the owner's equity. We have learned in first chapter when our revenue increases it shows the increase in owner's equity, and when we will withdraw the money or expenses increases it shows the decrease in owner's equity. The companies keep accounts for each these types of transactions. So companies will mention individually these accounts. Now owner's capital or owner's equity, investment by owner are credited owner's capital credited to the owner's capital account. So this we will separate create an account of owner's capital. Credits increases this account and debits decreases this account. So we have to understand this thing. If the credits increases this account and debits decreases it. When an owner invests cash in the business, the company debits increases and cash and credits increases owner's capital. When the owner's investment in a business is reduced, the owner's capital is debited or decreased. Now let's see the in illustration 2.5 shows the rules of debit and credits for the owner's capital account. Now debit and credit affects on owner's capital. Now when the capital decreases, we will record on debit side. When capital owner's capital increases, we will mention it on the credit side. Now we have learned the three accounts: one asset and liabilities. This account was owner's equity. If the owner's equity decreases, we will mention on debit side, and if the owner's equity increases, then we will plus on credit side, or we will enter on credit side. Now we can diagram the normal balance of owner's capital as follows. Normal balance owner's equity in illustration 2.6. When capital account normal balance to the credit balance. So in owner's capital account it shows normal balance on credit side, or it shows as credit balance. Now owner's drawing. An owner may withdraw cash or other assets for his personal use. Withdrawals could be debited directly to the owner's capital to indicate the decreases. When we will withdraw something from the business, it shows decreases in owner's equity. However, it is preferable to use a separate account called the owner's withdrawing. This separate account makes it easier to determine the total withdrawals for the each accounting period, that what we have withdraws in this period. So it will create ease. ऑनर्स ड्राइंग इज इंक्रीज्ड बाय द डेबिट्स एंड डिक्रीज्ड बाय क्रेडिट्स. नॉर्मली द ड्राइंग्स अकाउंट विल हैव अ डेबिट बैलेंस. नाउ लेट्स सी द इलस्ट्रेशन 2.7 व्हिच शोज द रूल्स फॉर डेबिट एंड क्रेडिट फॉर द ऑनर्स ड्राइंग अकाउंट. सो दिस इज द 2.7 illustration of debit and credit effect on account owner's drawing. In debit account, when the withdrawals increases, we will enter on debit side, and when the withdrawals decreases, then we will mention it on credit side. We can diagram the normal balance as follows. In 2.8 illustration shows the normal balance of drawing. When the debits increases from the credits, then it shows normally the debit balance in drawing account. It shows when the debits increases, it normally shows the debit balance. Now, what are the debit and credit rules for revenue and expenses? Now, let's learn about the rules of debit and credit for revenue and expenses. The purpose of earning revenue is to profit the owners of the business. The earning revenue is the basic purpose of this is to benefit the owners of the business. When company recognizes revenue, owners equity increases. Therefore, the effect of debit and credit on revenue account is the same as their effect on owners capital. So this is same like the owner's capital account, that is revenue account are increased by credits and decreased by debits. So this is same like the owner's capital. And in expense account have the opposite effect. Now the expense account is opposite of the revenue account or owner's capital account. In expense, the expenses decreases the owner's equity, because the expenses shows the decrease in owner's equity, since the expenses decreases the net income. When the expenses increases, then the company is decreases the its net income. It will proceed to the loss side, and revenue increases it, and the revenue is opposite than excess. If the revenue increases, then it shows the increase in net income or profit. It is a logical that the increase and decrease on the sides of expense account should be opposite of the revenue. Thus the expense account are increased by debits and decreased by credits. When the expense increases, they will be recorded on debit side, and when the decreases, they will be recorded on credit side. Now let's see the illustration 2.9, which shows the rules of debit and credit of revenue and expenses. Now this is the illustration 2.9, which shows the debit and credit effects on revenue and expenses. When the revenue decreases, it recorded on debit side, and when expenses increases, they will recorded on debit side. Now when revenue increases, it is recorded on credit side, like we have seen owner's capital account. In capital account likewise, this is in revenue account, we will when the revenue increases, we will record on credit side, and when expenses decreases, then we will mention on credit side. So we have learned about revenue and expense rules. Now the revenue and expenses normal balances, that either they show from the credit side balance or debit balance. The credits to revenue account should exceed the debits. The debits to the expense account should exceed the credit. Thus the revenue account normally shows the credit balance. Now the revenue account showing the credit balance, and expense account normally shows the debit balance. When it exceeds the credits, it shows the debit balance. In illustration 2.10 that we have shown in below, the normal balances for revenue and expense, as we seen in this illustration, these were the rules for certain accounts which are normally used in every organization or every business. So you have to remember these rules, because these rules are used in whole course and they are necessary. Without these rules you cannot proceed further. So remember these rules. Now this is the summary that you can understand easily. So this is the basic accounting equation: assets is equals to liability plus owner's equity and revenue and expenses. Now when assets increases, they are recorded in debit side, and when the expenses increases, they are also recorded on debit side. Now when assets and expenses increases, they will be recorded on debit side, and when these three accounts decreases, they will be mentioned or they will be recorded on debit side. When the assets decreases, they will be entered in credit side, and when these three accounts increases, they will recorded on credit side, and when the expenses decreases, they will be recorded in credit side. So this was the summary of this whole process that we have learned, and the rules of debit and credit. Now let's solve some question to clarify our understanding. Now question is that debit shows the increase in debit. If the assets increases and credit and decreases liabilities, we will mention it on credit side. So the true answer is, when the assets increases, they are recorded in debit side, and when liabilities decreases, they will be recorded on debit side. So the C option is right, we have learned. Let's see. Okay, we are done. Now this is the second question related to this accounting rules. The accounts that normally have debit balance are find out the which account have the normal balance. So we have learned that assets, owners, drawing and expenses have the always normally debit balance. So D option is right, we have learned. Now let's confirm it. Yes, hope you also have find the right answer because you have learned. So let's proceed. Now we have learned all the rules of debit and credit. Now this is the summary again to clarify your concepts, and because this is the foundation of whole course, you have to understand these rules. Now summary for debit and credit rules: the relationship among the assets, liabilities and owner's equity of a business. So this is the basic accounting equation, which is assets is equals to liabilities plus owner's equity, and this is the expanded accounting equation in which we will separately mention the accounts. Assets is equals to liabilities plus owner's equity, owner's drawing, revenue, expenses, etc. So the debit and credit effects on these accounts. If the assets, we have learned, assets increases, we will record on debit side, and if assets decreases, they will be recorded on credit side. The second, when liabilities decreases, we will mention on debit side, and increases we will record on credit side. Likewise, owner's capital, when decreases, we will mention it on debit side, and when it increases, we will mention in credit side, or we enter in credit side. When the drawings increases, they will be recorded on debit side, and when it will be decreases, we will record on credit side. When revenue decreases, we will record on debit side, and when revenue increases, we will record on credit side. And the last account, expenses. When expenses increases, we will record on debit side, and when expenses decreases, we will record on credit side. So this was the summary of debit and credit rules. The equation must be balance after every transaction. The total debits and credits must be equal. So these rules are very essential to make the accounting equation debits and credits equal. So we have completed the first learning objective of second chapter. Now this is our action plan inclusive. The Katie Brony has just rented the space in shopping mall. In this space, she would open a hair salon to be called as Hair It Is. A friend had advised Katie to set up double entry set of accounting records, so in which to record all of her business transactions. Identify the balance sheet accounts that Katie will likely need to record transactions needed to open her business. Indicate whether the normal balances of each account is debited or credited. Now we have to provide the solution of this statement whether the normal balances of each account is debited or credited, that because we have learned all things and we can do it easily. So let's try to solve. Now in action plan, determine the types of accounts. We have to determine first the types of accounts that are needed. Katie will need assets account for each and different types of assets she invest in business, and liabilities accounts for any debts she incurred. In second thing, understand the types of owners equity accounts. Only the owner's capital will be needed when the Katie begins the business. Other owner's equity accounts will be needed later. So let's try to solve this and understand. This is solution provided for you guys, and you will learn by yourself. And here are the related exercises material provided at the end of brief notes of second chapter, which will be provided and which you will download from the description box. I have provided below in description box. Go and download it and try to solve these types of problems. Now Katie would like to need the following accounts in which record the business transactions necessary to ready her hair salon for opening day. First of all, cash account. We have learned that it shows the debit balance and equipments. When assets increases, they will show the debit balance and supplies. These are the assets. These three shows the debit balance because they will show the increase in assets. And account payable, it shows the credit balance. And if the borrows money, notes payable credit, it also shows the credit balance. And owner's capital shows the credit balance. So these three accounts shows the debit balance, and these three accounts shows the credit balance. Now this was all about the first learning objective, in which we have learned account and what is debit and credit rules. So stay connected for the second learning objective and kindly solve these related problems. It will create more understanding and more grip on these topics. So thank you for watching, and if you haven't subscribed the channel, kindly do subscribe and share with your friends. Thank you.